Good evening, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel. Heartfelt words and thoughts from the man who knew Hank Gathers best, his close friend and teammate, Bo Kimble. And in fact, he reflects the feelings of basketball fans not only here in Southern California, but all across the country. What was to be the cap on a great collegiate run for Hank Gathers, this NCAA tournament, and a launching pad for a successful NBA career, has now, well, turned into a life that is cut far too short. Earlier this evening, here in Long Beach, the fans honored Hank Gathers with a moment of silence.
Thank you.
There will be memories of Hank throughout the evening as the Loyola Marymount players wear his number 44 on their jerseys. And the Aggies of New Mexico State, the opponents this evening, are also honoring the memory of Hank Gathers with black patches on their uniforms. And that is part of the setting here in Long Beach this evening for this first round West Regional game between the Lions of Loyola Marymount and the Aggies of New Mexico State. Earlier today, Michigan knocked off a stubborn Illinois State squad to advance. They will play the winner of this game. And Alabama defeated Colorado State and Arizona over at South Florida. Working alongside me this evening, once again, is Quinn Buckner. And Quinn, everyone's been asking Paul Westhead all week long how his team is going to be affected by all of this when they hit the floor. I don't think he knows, do you?
No, I don't think he knows, Greg. It's hard to tell. The kids can either come out flat from all of the emotion they've spent over the past few days, or they can come out and rally around the cause. It's going to be interesting to see.
Okay, well, certainly one thing that Loyola has to do is replace 29 points and 11 rebounds a game in the lineup.
Well, they'll do it physically with Chris Knight, the center. He's 6'9", player. But what they really have done, when Hank went out in December, they had everybody do a little bit extra. Better rebounding, better scoring, and the guy that does the best scoring in the country is Bo Kimble, and I expect we'll see him pick up a great portion of the scoring load.
Now, don't underestimate the New Mexico State Aggies. They've won 26 of 30 games so far this year. Fine athletes and a great backcourt.
Well, they got a great team. All of their starters average in double figures, and you don't see that a lot. But they're led by Randy Brown, but most notably Keith Hill. He's leading the team in scoring at 13 points. He's going to need to get a little more than that. I did a game earlier. I have seen him. I suspect he'll get it done.
All right, one more game to cap off West Regional play here in Long Beach, California. We'll tell you who's in the starting lineup when we come back in just a moment. Beautiful and balmy Long Beach, California, 30 miles south of the city of Los Angeles. The site for our game this evening between Loyola Marymount and New Mexico State. And it's time now to meet the starting lineups. Let's take you to our public address announcer, Dan Smith.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Long Beach Arena for tonight's NCAA first round game between the Loyola Marymount Lions and the New Mexico State Aggies. And now let's meet the starting lineups. For Loyola Marymount, at forward, a 6'5 senior from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 30, Bo Kimble. For New Mexico State, at forward, a 6'4 junior from Maywood, Illinois, number 32, Reggie Jordan. For Loyola Marymount, at forward, a 6'7 junior from Södertalje, Sweden, number 4, Per Stumer. For New Mexico State, at forward, a 6'8 junior from Chicago, Illinois, number 42, Michael New. For the Lions, at center, a 6'10 sophomore from Los Angeles, number 34, Chris Knight. For the Aggies, at center, a 6'8 senior from East Chicago, Indiana, number 30, James Anderson. For Loyola Marymount, at guard, a 6'1 junior from Riverside, number 12, Tony Walker. For New Mexico State, at guard, a 6'3 junior from Chicago, Illinois, number 3, Randy Brown. For Loyola Marymount, at guard, a 6'2 senior from Newport Beach, number 21, Jeff Fryer. For New Mexico State, at guard, a 6'4 senior from Houston, Texas, number 44, Keith Hill. And introducing the head coaches for Loyola Marymount in his fifth season with the Lions, Paul Westhead. And for New Mexico State in his fifth season with the Aggies, Neil McCarthy.
Aggies and Lions set to do battle. The winner gets Michigan on Sunday. We'll be back with the opening tip in a moment. Arena, as it has been all day long for West Regional play. Loyola Marymount making its third straight tournament appearance, its fifth overall, last year knocked out in the first round by the Razorbacks of Arkansas, while New Mexico State University is making its 11th appearance overall, but its first since 1979. And of course, back in 1970, it was a Final Four team. The officials for tonight, Sam Licklider, Allie Prescott, and Wally Tanner, and we are set to get underway. Chris Knight, number 34, in the dark jersey for Loyola Marymount.
Chris Knight,
and Michael New, number 42, jumps it in the white for the Aggies. In the opening tip, Bear Stumer diving for the loose ball, and here's Bo Kimble. He misses, puts it back, no good, rebound by Knight.
Well, Greg, this will be an up-tempo game, and the way Loyola keeps the tempo up as they try to put pressure here on a full court basis.
Whistle at center court. Randy Brown went down and the foul is on number four, Pierce Stumer.
Yeah, both teams want to run up and down the court. Loyola more than anybody else. They're averaging 124 points a game, so I think that says something for the way they like to get up and down the court.
That is a record-setting 124.8 points a game. Number three, Randy Brown, a 6'3 junior out of Chicago. Four of the five starters for the Aggies out of the city of Chicago.
Man-to-man right off the top here. Loyola's coming out man-to-man. They'll play it soft, try to make you make jump shots over the top.
And their intent is to slow down that Loyola Marymount attack. Brown, inside, off the basket, no, tipped up, no good. Kimble with the rebound. Tony Walker leads the charge in the middle to Knight. Whistle blows, and that's an offensive foul.
Well, Tony Walker pushed the ball up the court. That's his real strength in doing that, and that's one way to get Chris Knight in the game and hopefully get some points and potential rebounds to make up for the loss that they of the rebounding that they missed.
There's a whistle on the play, and Bo Kimble is charged with his first.
Fouls on 30. Bo Kimble, his first personal three-team fouls on Loyola, all awarded to New Mexico State.
Again, you see Loyola up. They want to put pressure and they'll speed the game up. We need to watch here, Greg, to see if Loyola will try to turn the tempo up in the half court by just going in what they call a helter-skelter defense to slow down pace away.
Reggie Jordan's shot doesn't go. Jeff Pryor has the loose ball, and Walker pushes it up again, and he's fouled at the top of the key. New Mexico State will play a matchup zone, but Paul Westhead, the Loyola Marymount coach, says if we have the time to recognize it, we're too slow.
He also said if we recognize the zone for them is a blur. They want to get the ball up as quickly as they can and get a shot. The zone is just something that everybody else is playing.
Kimble forcing his way in the lane, kicks it back out to Jeff Pryor.
Great, that's what I think we'll see a great deal more of. Bo Kimble takes the ball to the basket more when he knows he has to score. He'll probably shoot 18 or so free throws, but he'll also find people like Fryer.
Three-pointer for Fryer, and there's the steal. Here comes Walker. Walker. That's a 7-0 Loyola Marymount lead.
Well, they're backing up. I see Paul Westhead has just told his team, let's back up. If they want to slow it up, make them shoot jump shots.
Jordan and Brown playing catch at the top of the key. And inside now, Anderson. That's an offensive foul.
Loyola able to score in a lot of ways, but their defense is the thing that'll make them successful today. And when you push it up here like Tony Walker does, it's just nothing that Randy Brown can do but just try to get back and get the block.
There's another whistle blown on New Mexico State. And the momentum belongs to Loyola Marymount.
Well, it looks to me, and I think Neil McCarthy too, that that all of the enthusiasm that we were worried about whether the emotion would be channeled positively on the part of Loyola Marymount has been challenged the way they want it.
Kimble on the inside puts it up now, goes after his own tip, and that doesn't go. And Kimble grabs the loose ball. The leading scorer in the nation hits the two, and it's 9-0 Lions.
Good morning, everybody.
If you find that 2 hours of mowing your lawn feels like this, test drive the new Honda Hygrostatic Transmission Lawn Tractor and put the
and two seeds are still alive in the NCAA, although Illinois beaten by Dayton, Missouri by Northern Iowa. Here, Loyola Marymount has jumped off to the big lead, not so much with their offense, but with the defense, Quinn.
Well, it really is. You see what's going on here. They just keep going after the ball very aggressively.
Shot is up by James Anderson, and the whistle blows, and he'll go to the line.
That's an opportunity that Loyola missed that time. But the thing that New Mexico State has really gotten away from is when I watched them beat Nevada Las Vegas, these guys took the ball to the basket. Neil McCarthy's made a decision to hold it out. And in doing so, you take away some of the aggressiveness of people like James Anderson.
And you heard correctly. If you are unfamiliar with New Mexico State, they split two games this season with Nevada Las Vegas and tied the running Rebels for the championship of the Big West Conference. Anderson, a 65% free throw shooter, missed the first. And the Aggies are finally on the board. Here's Kimble for three. Around and out, and back comes New Mexico State. Brown leads the charge, dishes. Doesn't go, and Kimble up high for the rebound. Walker for Chris Knight. Inside, Kimble.
Brian, just like we talked about, they're getting it from everybody. Oh, Kimball's rebound, and you see Chris Knight has a chance to get into the action. Those are the kind of things they need to do. Get some good play from all of the team.
Fryer back for Loyola Marymount. Walker down the lane. Rebounded by New Mexico State. New Mexico State is usually a running, fast-breaking team. To LMU.
Well, they do run, Greg, but they don't run as much as Paul Westhead's Lions. 124 points a game average for Paul Westhead's crew. But the Aggies average 80 points a game. They really have done a poor job in terms of their shot selection, and that's caused them to get into a fast break game.
You see what the defense has done in the turnover department is number 20, Terrell Lowery, a 6'2 sophomore, comes into the game for Tony Walker.
Change the defense in that matchup zone.
Fryer's three-point bomb doesn't go. Whistle underneath, and the foul is on Bo Kimble. That's number two on Kimble. And Tom Peabody, number 11, into the lineup for Loyola Marymount. Chris Knight has a seat.
Well, they get Knight out of the game, but they bring in a guy, Peabody, that just hustles all over. They call him the human bruise. He hustles, dives on the floor for the loose ball.
Three on Michael New slams it home for New Mexico State. And back come the Lions. Fryer out of the corner for three. Stumer fouled on the shot.
Reggie Jordan, his second personal for Team Fouls on New Mexico State.
In 28 games this season, Loyola Marymount has scored 100 or more points 25 times.
Can you believe that? And the times they didn't score 100, they scored 91 or better. I mean, they just get it up. They figured they wanted to get 100 shots and have to shoot, obviously, about 50% to do that.
Pierre Stumer, the 6'7 junior from Sweden, who has started every game since arriving at Loyola Marymount. 12-13 now to 3. And Reggie Jordan brings it over the line for the Aggies.
It is tempting. That's what the Loyola will do to you. And if you're patient, those are the kind of shots you can get against Loyola.
And the steal by Brown turns it into two more. And there's a whistle and a charging foul. Ball at half court on Terrell Lowery.
Fouls on number 20. Terrell Lowery, his first personal. 16 fouls on the ball. Ball running to the Mexico State.
First personal, 16 foul. Brown inside, way off the glass. Nice move and a nice shot. And here come the Lions. And a near steal at center court, but Lowery comes back with it.
Well, the deflection made everybody stop momentarily and allowed Lowery to just keep going to get the ball. But Reggie Jordan has got long arms, so it's tough to get it around him. This is the tempo Loyola Marymount wants. They wanted a little more up-tempo on the turn, on their defensive end of the court, but once it goes in, they're getting their tempo going back to the offensive side.
Michael New with Kimble on him, and then back outside. Hill is 44 to Reggie Jordan, 32. Inside, Anderson doesn't get the roll. Kimble has the rebound. Lowery in a hurry down the lane. Partially blocked, and here come the Aggies. Hill leaves it for Brown. And Stumer goes up hard for the rebound. And there's a steal by Brown. Hill. And it's 15 to 11.
Coming right back at you, same tempo. What Randy Brown has started to do is play the inbounds pass, because Loyola typically throws the ball out to the right side. Randy Brown, knowing that, has gotten two steals.
Look at the passing by Loyola Marymount. And a travel in violation is called on Kimble.
Number 2 to Mexico State. In the game for Loyola, Tony Walker.
Number 12, Tony Walker back into the game, and Jeff Fryer will have a rest. There is the nation's leading scorer, Bo Kimble. You see what New Mexico State has done to Loyola Marymount after the initial cold spell at the start of the game. Jordan, off the glass.
They're becoming a little bit more aggressive, Greg. They're taking the ball at the basket. That's what they've got to do, force the action.
Lowery out of the corner, misses everything. Kimble there for the rebound and taps his home.
I think Bo Kimble is a big-time player. Bo Kimble is going to be a great pro. You see him doing a little rebounding there, but he's shown his scoring ability. He'll be a good player in the next level.
Kimble has 6 points and 8 rebounds. Hill, little dance step on the way in, draws the foul.
Tony Walker
draws his second foul. Kansas, an 8-point winner over Robert Morris. And number 33, Jason Trask, is into the game, replacing Michael New for New Mexico State.
Trask has been playing pretty well of late. He's a big body. They want to get in and try to get more rebounds. And with New going out of the game, he really wasn't giving them what they wanted on the offensive end. So if that's what they're going to give up, they figured, all right, let's get a body and try to get some rebound baskets if we just can't get in the floor of the offense.
Keith Hill, the Aggies' all-time assist leader, came into this game with 373 of them. And now number 21, William Benjamin, a 6'3 sophomore from Santa Monica, replaces Keith Hill.
Good replacement too, Greg, because he's a good defensive player, and he takes some of the ball handling pressure off of Randy Brown, which is keep Brown from being so tired.
Pass deflected, and here come the Aggies again. Benjamin dishes for Trask. Trask off the glass and in. And the Aggies have found new life.
Well, you wonder how much of the emotion all of a sudden took a lot of energy out of you. Emotion takes energy out of you. And you wonder how much of that happened after Loyola got off to the good start, and now they've gotten to a little bit of a lull. They have to find a way to pick themselves back up here.
31, Chris Scott in the lineup for Loyola, 6'8 freshman. And here's Trask on the baseline, draws the foul, and the basket counts.
That's three fouls, I believe, and that's on Bo Kimble. See, this is a good pass inside because all the defense came over to Anderson, and he put it over there. Kimball's got his arms up, but they weren't directly over his head. Sam Licklider called the foul.
And you know Bo Kimble is playing with a great deal of emotion tonight, perhaps a little too much.
Yeah, you've got to feel that that's one of the things that's happening. And he's also playing down in the position. He doesn't play that often. I mean, he periodically played inside in there, but now he's got to play it the entire game.
Jason Trask was not even close on that free throw. Kimble looking for a shot. Around and out. Loose ball. Trask had it. Lost it. New Mexico State has it. This is Brown.
Well, I think Paul Westhead has really taken a chance with Bo Kimble. I know he's the leading scorer. You need to get him out here. Give him a little breather. Keep the officials' attention away from him.
Number 15, Rick Flucky, is in the lineup. That's Benjamin, three-pointer on the way. No. And the whistle blows on Trask as he draws the foul going after the rebound.
Trask got caught in a good blockout by Chris Scott, young freshman from Union City, California. Somebody they feel that can come in, can just, he can score. He's having a little trouble getting his rhythm right now, but he's a good player to get in the game because he's a smart, heady player, somebody you need right now.
Kimble down the lane, has it blocked by Trask. And Kimble has it back and retains control. Lowery will start it again. Pryor outside, and the youngster Scott with the basket. Whistle underneath. Foul is on New Mexico State.
They call it on Flucky with Paul Westhead team in the 1-1 here.
His first person, 16,000 on New Mexico State.
Speaking of nicknames, Neil McCarthy, the head coach of New Mexico State, there calls Flucky my mad bomber. 11:37 to play. First half. We'll be back.
It's Wednesday morning in Ford.
Welcome back to a packed house here in Long Beach, California. Meanwhile, in the Midwest region at Indianapolis today, Georgetown over Texas Southern and Xavier of Ohio defeated Kansas State. Texas beat Georgia 100-88, and Purdue a winner late this evening. So it'll be Texas against Purdue, and Xavier meeting Georgetown for the right to move on to Dallas. Back to action. Peabody, number 11, and Terrell Lowery, number 20, with the ball now. Bo Kimble still on the court. He has the ball, looks for a shot on the baseline and doesn't get it. Lowery to the baseline. Round and out, tapped up, no good. Pryor with the rebound.
Still able to keep the ball alive.
Lowery for three. And that one looks like it'll go against Chris Scott.
But that's all right. A coach will take that. You got the young freshman Chris Scott in there battling to get an offensive rebound. Coaches will take that. You don't want to see it often, but every now and then, at least you know he's working to get the basketball.
Greg Gumbel along with Quinn Buckner in Long Beach, California. The fourth game of the day here in the West region, first round. Arizona, Alabama, Michigan have already advanced. And the winner of this game plays Michigan on Sunday as William Benjamin goes to the line. Missed the top end of the 1-1, tapped out of bounds, belongs to LMU.
Loyola's been able to stay in the game. I mean, they took off to that good lead, Greg, and then they just got flat. They went 8 for 21 at 38%, and New Mexico State was 8 for 15 at 53%. So it's really something that is you see the percentage. But the most important thing that we need to consider is that in terms of the shots taken, Loyola's got 21 shots up. You know, they'll take their chances with the percentages because they feel they'll come back in their favor. New Mexico State is about a 46% shooting team, where Loyola's the 50%, so they've got to feel that their chances are pretty good here.
Dean McCarthy liked his chances coming in. He says people just don't realize it, but we've got a pretty good ball club, and our athletes work hard. They just don't give up.
Greg, they don't give up. I watched them, as I said, against Nevada, Las Vegas, and they were easily out of that game. They went down 1-15, and then with like 6 minutes to go, they just picked it up and made some things happen, and they ended up winning the game.
James Anderson, number 30, back into the lineup.
McCarthy doing a good job rotating his players, getting a breather because of the tempo of the game.
Lowery hits them both, and the Lions go into their press. 21-18. Loyola Marymount with the lead. And Keith Hill will slow it down. Hill, Jordan, Brown, Anderson, and Michael New. And the whistle blows before he gets the shot away. Looks like the foul will go against Chris Knight. That's number 2 on Knight.
I suggest to you Chris Knight will get some more fouls, because what James Anderson has noticed is that it's easy to cut across the paint because Chris Knight does not do a good job getting positioned toward the ball and keeping his man away from the basket. So he'll get another foul reaching in there trying to keep Anderson from getting the ball.
Here's James Anderson, who twice this season scored 30 points for the Aggies. Career highs for the 6'8 senior.
Kind of an emotional player. He usually plays big down the stretch.
Three for Anderson, and it's 21-20, the Lions by one. Baseline move by Knight. Tapped up and in. Looks like Bo Kimble.
Bo is down on the block down there. That's the other way they can get him in the offense. Put him down on the block. Let him go for offensive rebound.
Kimble with 8 points and 11 rebounds.
It's close to a backcourt right here in front of us, Greg.
Loyola Marymount by three. Michael New turns on his hand and hits.
New Mexico State basketball, Michael New.
And here comes the Loyola Marymount Lions. Fryer out of the corner. Oh, what a bomb.
Well, that's the way they really want to play, because that's a 3-for-2 exchange. And obviously, if you do that most of the game, you got a better chance of winning the game.
New Mexico State has hit its last 5 shots from the field. 26-22, Lions by 4. Here's New. Lane for Jordan. Reggie Jordan, one of 3 players for New Mexico State who did not play basketball last year.
Well, Greg, Reggie Jordan didn't play basketball last year. He didn't play in high school, from Proviso East in that area with Doc Rivers, and he's never played in high school.
Kimball missed the easy one in the lane. Fryer with the follow.
That's killing New Mexico State. Offensive rebounds.
That's 8 for Fryer. Hill fakes the pass, lays it up. Nice play by Keith Hill.
New Mexico State basket by Keith Hill.
Don't blink. Here comes Loyola Marymount, although that'll be an offensive ball. Number 20, Terrell Lowery, draws his second personal. And he'll go to the bench as Tony Walker comes back.
Terrell Lowery of late had been playing well. He's averaging 14 points off the bench. But they've just brought back in their starter, Tony Walker. Tony Walker is quicker than Lowery going up and down the court.
And Bo Kimble also takes a seat on the Loyola Marymount bench. Aggies handling the press. And will now wait for the rest of the troops to catch up. Michael New, double team, loses the ball. Good help from Fryer and Walker.
Better get Fryer.
Here's Jeff Fryer for 3. Big rebound by Randy Brown.
Fryer's got to be the guy to show up big now, because they're taking the big gun. Kimball off a little breather with 3 fouls.
Hill to the basket, offensive foul. with this fast-paced game, we have probably seen as many offensive fouls in this as we would see in an entire game.
Well, it's because of the nature of the game. When it's up and down like that, players have a tendency to get out of control. I would suggest that it's more apt to happen in New Mexico State because even though they like to run, they're not accustomed to running at this pace. Loyola Marymount is.
Loyola crashing the boards twice as much as the Aggies so far. 8.5 to play, first half. Knight inside, back out to Stumer.
New Mexico State can keep Loyola, particularly now with Bo Kimble out of the game, in a half-court set, they got a good chance to win it. Because there's not many players that can be real good offensive players in a half-court set for Loyola.
There's a travel. On the sophomore, Chris Knight. The Lions have turned the ball over 9 times now, the 6 for New Mexico State.
Some teams, you would say, why so many turnovers for Loyola? They don't want to turn it over, but they run enough that they expect to get some turnovers. So they're not overly disappointed by the fact that they have that many early.
Anderson. Doesn't go prior with the rebound. Walker fouled from behind. Randy Brown, number 3, the guilty party for the Aggies. And into the game comes Rick Flucky, the junior from Laverne, California. And Bo Kimble back into the lineup for Loyola Marymount.
Well, you got two of the shooters in here. The Mad Bombers coming in. Rick Flucky shoots it, and everybody knows that Bo Kimble will get it airborne.
Tony Walker at the free throw line, shooting 1-1.
Talk to Tony Walker. He wanted to get to Loyola Marymount in the worst way because his game is up and down, and who else does it better than Loyola? So he had a lot of opportunity to go to schools, but he said, Quinn, this is the only place to go if you want to run.
Stumer with the defensive pressure, but the Aggies retain it, and Fryer kicks it out of bounds. And the clock stops with 7 minutes, 26 seconds to play. First half, we'll be back. Just under 7.5 to play here in Long Beach. Loyola Marymount with a 2-point lead on New Mexico State. And Loyola Marymount facing a team that hasn't been in the tournament for a while, since 1979. But look at some of the others. California since 1960, UConn since 79. And California and Connecticut have made the most of their opportunities so far. They have advanced past round number 1. New Mexico State trying to do the same here tonight. This is Flucky to Brown and Benjamin. They look down low. Michael New fighting for position on Pierre Stumer. Brown to the baseline. Soft shot too short.
Now Brown has got himself in a tough position. Neil McCarthy has him in one because Brown is one of the few players on New Mexico's team that's capable of creating his own shot. But that's not a good ideal against Loyola because as a point guard, if you create that shot, you leave yourself vulnerable to the fast break because there's nobody back in transition.
Flucky, 3-pointer on the way. Here comes Lowery, taps it out of bounds, and it belongs to... this. It will belong to Loyola Marymount.
Well, that's the officials helping each other out. I know Paul Westhead would hope that they'd do that, but it was clearly the ball, Loyola's ball.
Seems to me, Quinn, once you step onto the court, you open yourself up as vulnerable to the Loyola fast break.
Oh, well, there's no doubt about that.
There's a steal, and up ahead, Randy Brown. And this game is tied at 28. For Kimble, 3-pointer. Brown and out. Brown with the rebound.
Bo Kimble's having a tough time buying a shot, but Randy Brown has been playing a great game, controlling the tempo.
And they're tied up at center court.
Randy didn't think he got the timeout. He thought the official had made the 5-second call.
Paul Westhead's going to talk to his troops, too. 6:03 to play. We're all tied up.
Great. Sure, hotels, reservations. Fargo, North Dakota. No, we don't have a hotel in Fargo. In the area, yes, of course. Cleveland. Yes, that's true. It's 1,100 miles.
Why get the runaround? There are over 1,500 Holiday Inn hotels worldwide, so wherever you're going, call us.
How about the Miami Dearth, practically in the shadow of Fargo, North Dakota?
Holiday Inn. For worldwide reservations, call today.
Today we'll talk more about proper tennis procedures. Let's begin. Never, never try to hit too hard. In tennis, conservative attire is a must. Avoid overexcitement. Maybe we should go through this one more time.
It's Monday morning in Ford County.
That full-size Chevy pickup sure has a more advanced design than Ford.
Now that you mention it, the lines do remind me of modern neoclassic sculpture.
I see a lot of Bauhaus influence.
The understated simplicity even contributes to greater fuel efficiency.
Form follows function.
High fuel efficiency. No wonder people from Ford prefer Chevy trucks. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Southeast Regional play today, Northern Iowa with the upset of the Missouri Tigers, and in overtime, Minnesota over Texas El Paso. Also in the Southeast, Syracuse over Coppin State and Virginia beating Notre Dame. So the matchups in the Southeast look like this. At Richmond, Minnesota will play Northern Iowa and Virginia against Syracuse for the right to advance to New Orleans.
Well, I know a lot of people have to. I was surprised by the Northern Iowa score, but Eldon Miller is a great coach. He was at Ohio State, got that job in Northern Iowa, and did a great job there.
Under 6 minutes to play for the first half now. 28-28 tie. And New Mexico State has come back well after being blank for the first few minutes of the game.
28-28 with 5.5 to go. That bodes very well for New Mexico State, because if you're averaging 124 points a game by now, you've got to have close to 45 points, which Loyola obviously doesn't have.
What a shot by James Anderson to put him in front. Kimble to the basket. That's 10 for Kimble, and we're tied at 30.
That might be the shot to get him rolling, Brian. Brian, Greg, you got me for that before. At this point, this is Bo Kimble wanted to get it going. A shot inside normally gets you warmed up, and that's what Bo needs to do. I call you Brian.
I don't know, Bill. There's a shot. That's good.
Thank you very much.
By William Benjamin. 4:45. Here comes Kimble again. And that's an offensive foul, and that's number four on Bo Kimble.
Well, that is definitely a bad break for Loyola Marymount, because Bo's got to come out of the game now. You know, again, it looks to me like he's trying a little bit too hard. You see, he'll get the pass right here, and then he'll take it to the basket. And there's contact made, and the official felt that the position was definitely there by James Anderson, makes the call. Got Bo Kimble sitting down with four fouls.
Kimble remains in the game. And there's the steal by Loyola Marymount. And Kimble kicks it back outside. Peabody loses the handle, and it belongs to New Mexico State.
Having Bo Kimble in the game is just something that I would really wonder what Paul Westhead's got on his mind. I mean, this is your best player. You need to save him for the second half, because you're in a tight foul.
Meanwhile, the call has been reversed, and the Lions maintain possession. Peabody stripped to the ball by Brown. 3-on-2. Jordan. And it's a 4-point New Mexico State lead. Here's Kimble. Peabody, baseline, back outside, Scott. Doesn't get the roll. Scott gets his own rebound and tips it up.
Great effort by the young freshman in being in this battle and being able to keep his head, stay after the basketball. But you've got to get some players to step up. Traveling.
Reggie Jordan a little too anxious to get the pass off on the break. And number 21, William Benjamin, will come in to replace Keith Hill for the Aggies.
Keith Hill was bragging, trying to get back up and down the court. Neil McCarthy wisely got him out of the game.
Yesterday, we asked Paul Westhead if he does any special drills for this kind of a game, and he says, no, playing this way just keeps us that way.
No, it's, and not only that, but the practice. You see a good find by Peabody.
And the youngster, Chris Scott, has made his presence felt in this game. 6 points so far. Peabody trying to steal, but the Aggies will break the press again. And back comes Peabody, and he almost wrangles the steal, and let's see if he stays in the arena.
My man, the human bruise. But that's the kind of effort you've got to give if you're Loyola Marymount. You'll see right here, Peabody goes out, takes a little stand on the stand, comes out of bounds.
They tell us even in practice, Peabody does things like that.
Peabody's one of those kind of guys I used to hate to play against. He'll get you hurt.
And Bo Kimble now takes a seat on the bench with 3:27 to play in the half. He is 5 of 15 from the floor, 10 points, 11 rebounds. Lob almost clicked for New Mexico State. Jordan up and in.
New Mexico State basketball, Reggie Jordan.
All the way across court to Jeff Pryor.
Yeah, but you see the zone, that matchup zone is starting to come out a little bit more. You know, you get a little lead, your legs get a little more bouncing in it. New Mexico State seems to be doing that now.
Oh, good pass from the rookie Scott to Bear Stumer.
Yeah, well, Scott is showing me something here today. He's keeping his head and coming over here to visit us, too.
And Scott with the foul. That's number 2 on number 31, Chris Scott.
Got to applaud the effort.
Foul on 31. Chris Scott, his second personal. 42.
What's up, Chris?
Wait one, guys.
What's up, Tom?
Michael New at the free throw line for New Mexico State, shooting 1-1.
Under 3 minutes to play, and this is Michael New. Teammate of Randy Brown, Collins High School in Chicago, at Howard County Junior College.
Well, they played for Collins High School for Don Russell, who happens to be Cassie Russell's brother. And it's interesting, these guys have come here. On the New Mexico State team, they have 3 starters that weren't even on the team last year, and you see they're here in the NCAA tournament. I think a great deal of credit has to go to Neil McCarthy and his ability to put these guys together and get them to do the things he needs them to do.
Bo Kimble back into the lineup. Loose ball comes off to Randy Brown of New Mexico State. And there is a foul on Jeff Pryor.
Jeff Pryor has first.
That's number 1 on Pryor.
Pryor needs to also, he's got that foul call, but, you know, I would expect Paul Westhead would like to see Jeff Pryor get himself going offensively, because he's the one player that can take some of the pressure off the inside for the Lions.
This is the first. Stumer with the rebound. Under 2:40 to play. Kimble. Off the mark. Loose ball picked up. Peabody scores.
He scored with a lefty, too. And I mean, that was a great shot. Little lefty with a loft on it.
Back at Murray, and the Aggies score that one by James Anderson. And the basket will count, and the foul is on Michael New. Or appears to be Michael New.
No, they call it on Peabody.
Oh, Peabody. There's Tom Peabody. Michael New will shoot the free throw.
Michael New at the free throw line.
As I said a moment ago, scores 39-38. New Mexico State's got the tempo where they want it. They've been able to take good shots, get it inside. And when I say good shots, they pushed it up on the break. And they've taken shots within 8-10 feet of the basket, and that's what you need to do against Loyola, because if you take long jump shots, it's a long rebound, could end up with a long night.
And when you've got Loyola Marymount at 38 points, approaching 2 minutes to play in the first half, you've got a job.
Yeah, so some credit has to go to the New Mexico State defense.
New Mexico State 6 of 13 from the free throw line now. In the corner, Peabody, three-pointer, two-pointer, make it a two. And we're tied at 40. Pressure, losing the ball. Fryer.
See the press, being active.
The Lions by two with under 2 minutes to play.
Loyola Marymount does something that the kids should learn about basketball. When you're going for a steal, if you go up, the officials rarely call it. And if you watch Loyola Marymount, particularly when the guys come from the back on the zone press, they all reach up for the ball. And when it goes up, the official just feels you got mostly ball. Rarely do they call that a foul.
That's how you got away with all of that.
Oh, no question. No question.
Well, Jeff Fryer hits the deck. And the whistle blows and goes against New Mexico State. While we have a moment, we'll tell you that at the conclusion of every CBS Sports NCAA tournament broadcast, we select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team. Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund of each school to further assist qualified students in all chosen academic fields.
Jeff Fryer at the free throw line for Loyola, shooting
12,200 on hand here at Long Beach Arena. With a minute 19 to play in the first half, Loyola Marymount trying to add to a two-point lead. And Jeff Fryer hits the first.
Well, they've struggled a bit offensively, but as we talked about at the top of the show, what has been evident to me is that even though New Mexico State has played well and Keith Hill being one of those players, that Jeff Fryer and the rest of the Lions have picked up the slack. And everybody's starting to score a little more, rebound a little more, and play a little more aggressively defensively.
4-point Loyola Marymount lead. And here is the press. Hill clears it to Michael New. All the action yesterday and today has whet your basketball appetite. We've got about 9 hours worth of action coming your way tomorrow here on CBS. And the battle inside, and the foul is on Pierce Stumer. Pierce Stumer has been banging pretty good down low.
And he looks at the official and kind of waves his hand like, and says, oh, that's not a foul. Well, with the banging you're doing in that bear, clearly that was a foul.
And into the game again, Bo Kimble.
Bo's coming in, but the guy that's going out has really been part of the story here in the first half. Tom Peabody has just done a great job just getting his hand on the ball, making some tough shots. It's his kind of effort, I think, that's been contagious to the rest of the line.
Michael New hits his first one. Coming up at halftime, Jim Nance, Mike Francesa in our studios in New York. They'll update you on today's scores and highlights, and they'll set the stage for tomorrow's NCAA basketball championship action. Plenty of it. New hits them both. 44-42, Loyola Marymount. This is Lowery. All the way across court to Jeff Fryer. That's a three. Here come the Aggies. New to the baseline. Nice move by Michael New.
Comes right back at you.
And the steal.
That's Anderson.
By Anderson. 2-point Aggie lead, 46-44. 20 seconds to play, first half. No shot clock. Kimble to the baseline. And that'll tie it up.
Bo keeps throwing it up there. Bo knows how to shoot.
3 seconds. New.
He doesn't know it.
Know how much time, and that's it. Back and forth, and at the end of the first half, The score, Loyola Marymount 46, New Mexico State 46. And CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship continues after this.
New Mexico State and Loyola Marymount tied at 46, the final game of the first round in the 1990 tournament. Jim Nance along with Mike Francesa here in New York. Mike, by the way, a behind-the-scenes man the last 8 years in the tournament, popular radio host here in New York City, and a man with a lot of opinions, I might add. What about the first half here, Mike?
Well, we talked about emotion for the team and specifically for Bo Kimble. He has four fouls, picked up four in the first half, had 12 points, averages 35, so the emotion was there in the beginning. Tailed off. Can they channel it in the second half?
All right, Mike, we're going to talk about all the day's scores, but first let's get another update on the baseball situation. Negotiations ongoing into the night, and live right now at the Summit Hotel in New York, our colleague Jim Gray. Jim?
Okay, Jim, they've been meeting for a little over 3 hours now over at the commissioner's office. First time in 9 days that the players and owners have gotten together. A bit earlier in the evening, I spoke to Donald Fear, the union chief, and he said that some progress is being made, but that no deal is imminent. Now, the owners did make a new proposal today, and the union studied it for about 5 hours. What that new proposal entails is a 30-man roster for the first month of the year, about 156 new jobs for 30 days, an increase in the minimum salary to $100,000, an increase in the pension, an expansion, possibly up to six teams in the 1990s. What the new proposal didn't address was salary arbitration eligibility. The players wanted it at 2 years, the owners wanted to remain at 3 years. And Donald Fear said going into tonight's meeting that that is still our main objective and our main concern. Now, going into the meeting tonight, Commissioner Faye Vincent was asked about the new proposal.
Do you feel, in your opinion, that this new proposal was a positive step forward?
Well, it's only positive if it works. I hope it works.
The players' executive board will meet here in New York tomorrow to examine the new proposals. But many players have told us here at the hotel tonight that regardless of whether there's an agreement today or tomorrow, that the April 2nd opening day would just be impossible, and they feel that April 9th would be about the earliest that they could start baseball. Jim?
All right, Jim. Could be a long night ahead. A sad note in the sports community tonight. Tom Harmon, the Michigan tailback who won the Heisman Trophy in 1940, died of a heart attack in Los Angeles. Harmon had just completed a round of golf in a tournament which he and his partner had won. Tom Harmon was 70 years old. Turning back to news of college basketball, the North Carolina State University trustees have reportedly scheduled an emergency meeting for next Tuesday to discuss, quote, personnel matters. This is an apparent reference to the unresolved status of Coach Jim Valvano, whose basketball program has been the target of investigations and allegations concerning point shaving and other improprieties. The team is currently on NCAA probation. Mike, what do you make of this meeting Tuesday?
What this means is there's an ongoing negotiation to settle Jim Valvano's contract. There's a hefty buyout in excess of $500,000 in that contract, a clause that really has to be settled once and for all. And for all concerned, for Valvano and NC State, it's time they parted ways.
All right, agreed. Let's go to the board today in first round action again. The second day of the first round, the big shocker, Northern Iowa over Missouri by 3, a buzzer beater there. However, Missouri fought back from a 12-point deficit, tied it with 30 seconds to go. Nathan Bunton put it up, was fouled, got the free throw to tie it. But in the closing seconds, watch Maurice Newby of Northern Iowa hit the long three. No timeouts left for the Tigers, so they just had to throw at the length of the court. A win and a shocker as a three seed is defeated. Mike, Missouri playing poorly coming in, but still a big surprise.
A surprise, yes and no. They were playing poorly, and they're the only one of the top 16 seeds not to advance to the second round. The key, Jim, Anthony Peeler, mysteriously down the stretch, nothing. Today, 3 points.
You know, Northern Iowa's Jason Reese was asked if this win puts them on the map. He says, hey, we've been on the map. We're from Cedar Falls. And today, Northern Iowa moves on in the tournament. Next up will be Minnesota, another Big Ten team that won in overtime, the third one in the first round to go to overtime and win it. Big Ten 5-2 after the first round. Syracuse over Coppin State. Coppin State shot only 29% from the floor. Next for Syracuse will be Virginia, all the way today against Notre Dame. Terry Holland's team wins, and Holland stays alive. He's retiring after the season. ACC looks strong, Mike.
First round story, ACC 5-0. The selection committee didn't show them that much respect, Jim, especially Georgia Tech, but they're 5-0 after one round.
All right, elsewhere, Midwest, Purdue was down one at the half, went on a 16-4 stretch midway through the second half to beat stubborn Northeastern Louisiana. Texas hit the century mark thanks to Travis Mays, the all-time scorer in the Southwest Conference, 44 points in that victory. Xavier over Kansas State. Watch out for Tyrone Hill, 29 points, and including 15 out of 16 free throws. Next for the Musketeers will be Georgetown. And that combo, Mutombo and Morning, 14 out of 15 from the floor, leading them to victory over Texas Southern. Kansas, a winner over Robert Morris, the second-seeded Jayhawks, struggled in this game, but won by 8. Ricky Callaway, 9 out of 10 from the floor, 4 out of 4 free throws for 22 points. UCLA was down 11-0, but fought back to win as Trevor Wilson, 23 points, 9 rebounds for the Bruins. And St. John's over Temple. The Redmen looked good today. They had lost the last 3 times in the tournament in the first round, but today a victory by 16. Duke a winner, the largest margin of victory in the first round, 35-point win as Coach K picks up career win number 300. Michigan and Illinois State, and Steve Fisher now 7-0 in the tournament. Of course, the defending national champions from a year ago. This game was tied with 1:30 to go, but the Wolverines scored the game's final 6 points. And Alabama hit its first 8 three-point attempts. Robert Horry hit his first 6 three-pointers, and they outshot Colorado State by 17. Arizona was down 5 at the half, came back to win it, as Brian Williams had 21 in the second half, a career-high 28 points for Brian Williams. The lineup for tomorrow, just a short time from now, really, we start off nationally with California against Connecticut, 12 o'clock Eastern time, 9 on the West Coast. That'll be followed by either Ohio State, UNLV. Some will see Clemson against LaSalle. And then it's North Carolina, Oklahoma in the third game of our quadruple header. Some will also watch Ball State, Louisville, a matchup of the Cardinals there. Cal Santa Barbara against Michigan State. And then we top it off with LSU, Georgia Tech. And others will watch Dayton against Arkansas. So a great weekend of basketball coming up as we move into the second round. We still have one last first round game to go. Back to the second half as we continue on the road to the Final Four.
Welcome back to Long Beach, everyone. Bo Kimble be in the spotlight as we begin second half action. Not an outstanding first half for a young man who says he likes big crowds and pressure games.
Well, he really hasn't shown up the way he's capable of showing up. And what's really going to hurt him, obviously, is the 4 fouls, because now he can't take the ball to the basket as aggressively as he would like to.
Mexico State going to slow it down and take their time right out of the gate.
Well, that's how they started the game off, and they had success with it.
Move inside by Jordan. Loose ball picked off by Anderson. And this is Keith Hill. Incidentally, 12 points in the first half by Bo Kimble give him an even 1,000 on the season.
But he's got to do better than that for the second half, Greg. He just is too much of the offense for him. He has 12
points. Stumer with the rebound. Starters. Here's Kimble, baseline.
And Bo stepped back to that three-point line. I mean, he looked down to find his place. That's a good kick out by Chris Knight. Not normally a shooter, finding it the number one scorer on the team.
So Kimble off to the good start here in the second half, and it's 49-46 Lions.
But Greg, with him in the front of the press, it makes the press somewhat ineffective, even though that pass is thrown away, because he can't be aggressive. He's just kind of there, and Neil McCarthy's Aggies can come at him, and he's got to back up with 4 fouls.
Walker into the lane, and Fryer saves it. Aggies in the zone defense. Kimble backs up and pops one through.
They let him catch the ball. How you let the leading scorer in the nation catch the ball in the paint?
But then he leaves the paint.
Well, he'll back out on you now. One thing he's not afraid of is to step out and shoot. There are a lot of people here looking at him to play in the next level already, because they know he's got range and he can create his own shot as well.
Kimble is at the first 5 points of the half, the only 5 of the half, 51-46 Loyola Marymount.
You know, you're going at halftime and you know that the nation's leading scorer is struggling. You're Neil McCarthy, you're worried about what he's going to do in the second half, because he tries to make up for lost time if you're Bo Kimble.
Reggie Jordan off the side. That's his pointer, and it's a 3-point Loyola Marymount lead. 10 points for Jordan. Walker saves the pass. Kimble into the lane, lost it, and drew the foul. Let's see if it was a shooting foul. Bo Kimble will go to the line. And this will be a little bit different. No, he's not going to go to the line. They rule that he was not in the act of shooting.
One of the few times.
Fryer, long range.
That was a rain drop. I mean, that dropped out of the sky.
15 for Jeff Fryer. Good, tapped out of bounds, and it belongs to New Mexico State.
New Mexico State has had their opportunities, and I'm sure that Neil McCarthy wants his team to push it up, but they've got to get it into the basket. I thought that time Reggie Jordan had a chance to take it in and dunk it, but he chose to pass it off, and he missed the follow-up.
Ninth time in 15 seasons that a Neil McCarthy coach team has reached 20 victories in a season.
I think he's proven, Neil McCarthy's proven what kind of coach he is. He was back-to-back coach of the year in the conference in the Big West, so he's shown everybody he can do this very well.
Aggies being patient.
Being patient, taking away some aggressiveness.
Shot clock is at 8. And Hill puts it up. Two-pointer by Hill. And back comes Tony Walker on the drive and the foul. Tony Walker, a blur coming down the court, and he'll go to the line once he recovers.
Well, he is definitely a blur, but he had Jeff Fryer on the left of your screen, and because everybody went out there, he was able to go to the basket, and Mike Lemieux got there late. Hit the backboard, and he hit Tony Walker as well. Walker looking at it, completing the three-point play.
Michael New draws his second personal, and Walker looks to make it a three-point play. Doesn't fall. Out of bounds to the Aggies. Finally finds Jordan.
Yeah, but he throws it right to Fryer.
And Fryer had it tapped away. Here's Walker. Kimble for three.
Better get out there. Better get out there.
Three-point basket. 20 points for Kimble. Loyola Marymount 5 for 5 shooting in this half from the field. And Anderson is fouled by Jeff Fryer as he goes to the hoop. .37 to play, and it's a 9-point Loyola Marymount lead. We'll be back.
You want a games? It's quadruple NCAA, but four, count them, four games. It's quadruple NCAA championship excitement. What a Saturday!
Along with Quinn Buckner, I'm Greg Gumbel. 59-50 Loyola Marymount. It was a 46-46 tie at halftime. But the Lions have come out bombing here in the second half. 5 of 13 threes, but 3 out of 3, and they're on a 13-4 run, and Bo Kimble has begun to light it up. That is John O'Connell for Loyola Marymount, and he's got some stitches and a black eye, the result of a fight in practice with teammate Terrell Lowery. And Quinn, they said they were tired of beating up on each other in practice. They were anxious to play a game.
Well, I've been in that situation before. They've waited so long, and under the circumstances, they had played to the point in practice that they were just tired of beating each other. Said, let's get a game going. And they showed their emotion early in the game. It took their toll on them, I thought, in the first half. But they've seemed to come back and have settled down. John O'Connell just happens to have some evidence of that fight.
Michael New in the lane. Nice move. Stumer outlets. Look at the big guy Knight run the floor. Chris Knight goes 6'9", and there's another steal. Here's Knight again. Bo Kimble for three. And another steal. Fryer out of the corner. This will be a very unusual situation. Bo told us of some special thoughts on his first trip to the free throw line tonight.
I'm going to shoot my first free throw left-handed, and it's because Hank Gathers tried so hard to improve on his left hand, and it's in remembrance of Hank, and it's something I want to do for this year.
That'll happen when we come back. 14:46 to play on the floor. Loyola Marymount putting it in gear. Long Beach, California, where the Lions of Loyola Marymount have outscored New Mexico State 18-4, and the big story has been Bo Kimble, who was only 6 of 17 in the first half, but has begun to bomb away. And as you heard him say before we took a timeout, Bo is going to take his first free throw left-handed in honor of his friend, Hank Gathers.
Well, excuse me, I was a terrible free throw shooter, but that one looked good from the time it left his hand.
An amazing young man, and one right-handed for good measure. 66-50, Loyola Marymount.
New Mexico State has to be careful not to try to get them all back in one trip down the court.
Jordan.
New Mexico State basket by Reggie Jordan.
66-52, and Walker pushes it back in a hurry. Yeah. That pass intended for a breaking Bo Kimble, and never got there.
Well, Paul Westhead is trying to say that that the defensive play, generation, if you can't move up and down the baseline after a made basket, you can.
Aggie turnover. Fryer, three. Was from the outer marker. Bo Kimble with the interception.
That rattled.
And there's a steal by Walker out of bounds and belongs to Loyola Marymount. New Mexico State, the number 6 seed, is esteemed not easily rattled. Fryer for three. Two-on-one break, out of bounds, and look at the hustling Tony Walker.
Great effort. Great effort by Walker to get back to break up that play. Just getting a little hand from Paul Westhead. You know, you don't see that very often. We got Walker going out of the game, and Walker's been instrumental because he's pushed the ball up the court, and Loyola's been able to get some easy shot opportunities. But Lowry's as capable. He's just not as quick as Tony Walker.
Loyola Marymount has outscored the Aggies 28-6 in this second half. We still have 13:50 to play. And as you might well expect, the Lions have their fair share of supporters here in Long Beach. A good shot off the baseline by Reggie Jordan. 14 for Jordan. Lions of 6 of 7 threes in this half. Make it 6 of 8 now as Kimble misses. Right at him, too hard off the glass.
Marymount's got a game.
Fryer back to Lowery, traveled. And into the game, number 11, Tom Peabody, replaces 34, Chris Knight.
You lose a little bit in height here, but Knight was tired. Westhead got him out, but you know what Tom Peabody will do on the hustle part of the game, so you gain something from that advantage.
Top of the key, Hill. And Stumer with yet another rebound. Stumer has done the job on the boards tonight. Good pass for Peabody. Shot didn't fall. And there's a steal and a foul at half court. And Terrell Lowery does doesn't think so.
Well, Bo Kimble is over to comfort Terrell Lowery, but Bo was backing out away from it because it was close for Bo getting his fifth foul. But again, the tempo is starting to move toward Loyola Marymount. They want it up and down. They've gotten some turnovers over it, out of it. And New Mexico State has got to be careful here. That foul really helps New Mexico State because they can slow the tempo back to where they want it.
Here comes Rick Flucky, number 15, into the lineup for New Mexico State.
He's the three-point shooter on the club. Came in to give Reggie Jordan a break. Reggie Jordan was almost pulling the shorts off. He was so tired.
Flucky suffered a broken jaw against Texas Tech on the 18th of this month. That one comes up short, and here come the Lions.
They won't get Fryer.
Fryer for three. Good rebound by Michael New. And Flucky is going to put it up for three. Oh, he can't find the range. Lowery for three. The only thing missing from this track meet is a baton.
The baton is the ball.
Lowery down the lane, two.
As I said, the tempo was clearly moving in Loyola Marymount's favor. Taking those quick jump shots made New Mexico State think that they could start taking them. They're losing the composure they had in the first half.
Michael New, short pop is good, 76-56. And Jeff Fryer open for three. Kimble with a rebound and fouled by Flucky.
On 15, Flucky his second personal. Four team fouls on the Aggies. Tony Walker back in the game for Loyola Marymount, replacing Jeff Fryer.
Jeff Fryer out of the game. Tony Walker back in.
Loyola ball.
Jeff Fryer's missed his last couple of shots. He needs a breather, but he's been able to get his shots off because he's been able to get to his spot on the court. In the first half, he couldn't get to that spot. That he comes down the court, right spot, right at the three-point line, and he just waits, and either Lowery or Walker will get him the basketball, getting him a little breather now.
Lions shooting the ball much better in the second half.
Tempo is more like they like, Greg. That's the reason they can shoot it. This is their rhythm.
Kimble way up top to Stumer. Clock is at 33 for Loyola Marymount. That's winding down.
Well, that's a long time for Loyola Marymount to have the ball. They like to get it up in 3 or 4 seconds.
Batted away. Lowery on the drive saves it. Shot clock at 20. Kimble for Peabody. And back up top, saved by Lowery. Shot clock down to 11 now.
Here, Paul Westhead, Holland, pull it out.
Stumer for three.
See, he can make them too. That's what everybody doesn't know about Pear Stumer. He used to trail and make those shots. He'd trail on the break and he could make those shots. So now you got to come out and guard him. And Pear Stumer is a good passer.
23-point lead for the Lions. Flucky is open for a three. And misses everything.
That's not the shot you want. That's a long shot. If you miss it and it hits the rebound against the rim, you got a fast break going in the other direction. Neil McCarthy didn't like that at all. He's giving Flucky a little bit of break. We'll talk to him about when to take that shot, when not to.
Meanwhile, Bo Kimble. Peabody for a rebound. Dishes for Kimble.
Can't say enough about Peabody.
Meanwhile, Bo's numbers are up to 29 now as the Aggies throw it away.
Greg, they're falling apart. They are just falling apart.
That's the 20th turnover. New Mexico State giving it up far too many times. Pear Stumer goes to the bench.
Well, they come in with a good player with Chris Knight. He was really one of the reasons that Loyola stayed in it in the first half.
Lowery. Tapped out of bounds by the Aggies. When the numbers begin to get up in the stratosphere, the Aggies don't do so well. Only four times have they hit the 100-point mark.
Well, I'll tell you what's amazing. Loyola Marymount had 46 points at the half.
They now have 84 points, and you got 10 minutes to go in the game. And, you know, so they scored twice as much as they did in the entire first half.
That's another three for Kimble. That's a three-pointer for James Anderson.
Three-point basket by James Anderson. Three-point basket.
Lowery. Front rim, out of bounds, belongs to New Mexico State. Bo Kimble, incidentally, now with 32. Averages 35.3. Anderson fouled before he got the shot off by Lowery.
On 20, Terrell Lowery, his fourth personal.
Terrell Lowery draws his fourth, and Chris Knight, Jeff Fryer, ready to check back in for the Lions.
In the game for the Lions, Jeff Fryer.
Lowery was doing a good job pushing the ball up, and as well, Bo Kimble is going out of the game to get a well-deserved rest if you hear the round of applause.
Kimble has 32 points, 14 rebounds. And a little disagreement. Chris Knight, no sooner had he come off the bench than he and Michael New had a little disagreement.
Well, they're a little feisty here now. You know, you got to wonder, you know, Chris Knight was a player who had, at one point mentioned after, you know, the death of Hank Gathers that he might not ever play basketball again. But you see, he's coming out playing with a great deal more enthusiasm. And wisely, Neil McCarthy feels to get Michael New out of the game because you don't want to get him a foul because he's emotionally involved right here.
They had to do a little talking with Chris Knight. Chris had wanted to play so badly, he felt for a moment that he almost wished that Hank Gathers wasn't around, and they had to tell him, no, none of that was your fault. Anderson's shot doesn't go, and Scott has the rebound. Pass by Peabody. Jordan.
Oh yeah.
Jordan lost it on the way up, regained it in midair and dunked it.
Oh, he'll dunk it. He's only 6'3", but he's got a wingspan like a guy 6'8".
Scott. Knight follows and hits the deck.
Easy. Everybody easy.
Let's take a look at Reggie Jordan on that drive again.
Well, he got the ball, and there's no question he's going to dunk. He was going to try to take it in one hand. He loses it, but he's still going up and able to get control of it. But I knew he was going to dunk. You can see it in his eyes. First time he's seen a vacant basket all game.
Three personals on Chris Scott. Benjamin, nice feed for Jordan. And it's 84-63. 18 for Jordan.
Call a foul on James Anderson over the top there.
You know, Neil McCarthy was telling us that, said, what is it about your guys that's special? And we mentioned before, they play hard and they don't give up, but they're also feisty.
Well, you know what? Getting those kids from Chicago, they're normally playing in the Chicago Summer League with Doc Rivers, Isaiah Thomas when he's there. And so they've played against very high-level competition, so they don't get frustrated. If you can play in that league, you can play anywhere.
Bo Kimble back into the lineup. Close to a steal. Peabody doesn't get it. Back come the Aggies, and there's Jordan again. Doesn't get it in the lane. Stumer for Lowery. Kimble. Front rim, no. Hill rebounds and a foul.
On Fryer. Tried to come underneath, and the official caught him.
Foul is on Jeff Fryer. That's number three.
16 fouls on Loyola Marymount. Fouls awarded to New Mexico State.
There's a bad pass stolen underneath, and that'll be a goaltend.
Frustration. Reggie Jones knew he threw a bad pass and got frustrated and came over and tried to block it.
What's that?
Lions looking to advance against Michigan on Sunday. Meanwhile, nice lay-in down low by Reggie Jordan, who has 20.
That's Lowery. That's his fifth foul, isn't it?
That is indeed. That is number five on Terrell Lowery, who will leave the game with 8 points and a couple of assists.
Terrell Lowery, his fifth personal foul, he leaves the game.
Well, he's played a good game. He's been able to come in and spell Bo Kimble. And you see the leadership of Bo Kimble there. He's coming over telling Terrell, you know, you played a good game. Don't worry about it. But now, Tom Peabody becomes much more important in the scheme of things because Lowery pushes the ball up and keeps everybody involved on the offensive end. Peabody's got to come up with some more steals and defensive play to get some baskets for Loyola Marymount.
While we're talking about losses of note here in Los Angeles, in the Los Angeles area, the death yesterday of Tom Harmon, former Heisman Trophy winner at the University of Michigan. Former broadcaster as well, passed away of a heart attack at age 70. All the Michigan followers out here aware of that and our sympathies to Tom Harmon's family. That's the first trip to the free throw line this half for the Aggies after going 8 for 15 in the first half. William Benjamin hits them both. 86-67 as we approach 8 minutes to play here in the second half.
New Mexico State has come out of their matchup zone. They've gone straight man-to-man, Greg.
Didn't stop Jeff Pryor, who drove to the bucket for two.
Well, there's got to be better help out on the point of part of New Mexico State, but you've got to do a better job helping out.
That foul on Tom Peabody, and that's his second.
Tom Peabody, second personal.
The human bruise.
Always after. I like players like that. I mean, there got to be people like Bo Kimble that can shoot the ball, but you've got to have people like the human bruise, Tom Peabody, to get the ball for you when it's on the floor.
Keith Hill hits the first. And he hits the second. We'll take a timeout. 7:55 to play second half. Loyola Marymount is charged.
Build an event, and they will come. Build a big league event, and they will come.
Hi, I'm Joe Garagiola.
I'm Johnny Bench.
Starting this weekend, we'll be calling the play-by-play of the biggest event of the season.
7:55 to play here in Long Beach. Loyola Marymount leading New Mexico State. And tomorrow, CBS Sports continues its coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship with a second-round quadruple header. Four games starting at noon Eastern time. California, Connecticut at 2:25. Ohio State, UNLV, or Clemson, LaSalle. Those three at 4:40. And then those two at 7 Eastern time. Lots of hoops coming up tomorrow here on CBS.
Well, I guarantee you, I'm going to be in good position to take some look at it.
Here's Stumer on the drive. That's 90 for Loyola Marymount. And Stumer has 9. Benjamin out of control on the drive. Here comes Walker. Right around his man, Bo Kimble for 3.
Horse, like playing horse.
That's his average, 35 points for Bo Kimble. Benjamin, 3-pointer.
3-point basket by William Benjamin. 3-point basket.
Walker for Fryer. And let's take it the other way. Brown. Basket, no bucket. Offensive foul.
Well, Randy Brown thought he had a clear path. Paris Stumer just helping some other ways on the court. See, everybody doesn't have to score. Randy Brown clearly thought he had the way there. But you don't have to score to be a player on a team. You can take charges. You can rebound. You know, I'm sure Neil McCarthy would have loved to see Randy pull up for the little jump shot as opposed to taking it in. But it's a heady play by Paris Stumer.
New Mexico State has not lost two consecutive games all season long. This would be their second in a row. Kimble fakes, goes around, off the glass. No. Here comes Benjamin.
and they'll slow it down a little bit.
Yeah, for a three-pointer. That's slow it down for you, all right.
That's 10 for Benjamin. And it's 93-75. Fryer. And Kimble with the rebound goes back up. Remember, Kimble has played this half with four personal fouls.
It looks to me like he's starting to get a little tired too, Greg, because the last shot he missed, I mean, he really kind of trucked to get back down the other end of the court. You got to wonder, what is his conditioning like? He's had some time off. Does he have it to finish the game?
Rick Flucky is all over the human bruise. Tom Peabody. You have the human bruise and the Matt Plummer. Kimble on the drive, fouled by Keith Hill. That's three on Hill.
Keith Hill's got his hands full trying to guard Bo Kimble, because when a guy can make a jump shot like Bo Kimble, you go out to guard him, and Bo shows you what he can do on the other side. He takes it to the basket and draws the foul. And I really expected to see Bo Kimble take the ball to the basket a great deal more, because that's the way to get production without taking the offense or the flow of the offense away from his teammates.
Understandably, there has been a tremendous outpouring of feelings via the written word for Hank Gathers, and Bo Kimble wanted us to pass on to everyone that he is receiving those notes, those cards, those letters. And if he doesn't get a chance to thank everyone personally, he would like to do so through us.
Yeah, he's eternally thankful for it. He thought it was, for him, it was therapeutic not only to talk about it, but to be able to read the notes and get the condolences that he got.
75, shot is short. Benjamin follows.
Dude just played pretty big here off the bench. Offensive rebound, three-point shot. He's normally noted for his defensive play, so he's really come in well off the bench.
Benjamin has 12. Came in averaging six a game. There's a whistle, and the foul looks like on James Anderson.
You start seeing these fouls come up now, Greg, and some of it is due to the fact that I know New Mexico State runs, but you don't run this much in practice. No chance.
Pierce Stumer at the free throw line shooting 1-1.
Here's Pierce Stumer, who's a 78% free throw shooter. From Sodentalia, Sweden.
Yes, you get that word. I love it when you get that word.
Rebounds for Stumer. Michael New Flucky out of the game. Michael New back in.
Need more rebounding. You get Michael New back in the game, and he's a little older player, so he'll know how to make some good decisions where Flucky was taking some bad shots.
3-point attempt, no good. Anderson follows. Now watch the Lions come back in a hurry. Stumer, oh, what a good move.
That's what the three-point shot will do to you. Draw the defense, but Paris Stumer took it to the basket, able to give it to Bo Kimble.
Benjamin, nice bounce pass, but Anderson's shot doesn't go. Here comes Walker. Walker fouled, no call.
There's no foul. What are you?
And Tony Walker comes back and grabs.
They call it an intentional foul. It's a good call by the official. Walker, you're right. He was fouled, and he said something, and the official didn't make the call. But there's no question about it. You see right here, Anderson go for the shot. And if there's no attempt to go for the ball, there clearly is no attempt on the part of Walker. He knocks Anderson down, get two foul shots, and the ball back.
And since James Anderson wasn't carrying the ball on his shoulder, can't say that Tony Walker was going for the basketball.
In the tournament, when you play against a team like Loyola Marymount, you have to have good shot selection, because I don't care who you've played all year long, you just have not played anybody that runs up and down the court like this. It's not there.
And as you pointed out, You can't practice for this.
No, you can't, and that's what most people make a mistake about. You can't practice against strong defense or a running game. This is the best conditioned team that I've seen all year, Loyola Marymount.
The lob, getting closer to a shot.
Might have been a better idea to shoot than to try to lob it.
All the way into the basket, tapped home by Bo Kimble. Number three is Greg Walker into the lineup. 41 for Bo. And Anderson answers with two. This is Walker.
By James Anderson.
Walker is a 5'11 freshman from San Jose, California. Doesn't get much playing time, but getting it now in the absence of Terrell Lowery, who fouled out.
He's really in there to push the ball up the court, try to create some opportunities to get some shots off.
Fryer up short. Whoa. Kimball.
Oh. Oh. Oh, knows basketball.
31 points here in the second half for Kimball, 43 for the game. Reggie Jordan puts two more on the board. And we are at 320 for the game. 103-83.
You can hear Paul Westhead saying, oh, slow down, slow down. Walker's in here a little too enthusiastic.
Kimble. And Knight, trying to follow, commits the foul. You know, earlier in the week, Bo Kimble had jokingly said that he was going to score 70.
Well, he got off to a little bit of a slow start. But I'm telling you, he's making up for lost time. You see, he's got 31 in the second half. When they played without Hank Garris, the two games they did, the first game, he had 54. The next game, he had 46. So he figures out ways to score. He did get off to a slow start, but he's made up for some lost time here.
That 54 is his high for the season. He hit 54 on the 4th of January against St. Joe's. Stumer taps it out of bounds. We'll take a timeout with 3:03 to play, and Loyola Marymount leading it by a bunch.
For the best shave a man can get, close.
We'll continue to update you on what has happened so far today in the East Regional play in Atlanta. Duke over Richmond and St. John's defeating Temple 81-65. Other winners today, UCLA over UAB and Kansas defeating Robert Morris. So for the right to advance to East Rutherford, New Jersey, it'll be St. John's against Duke and the Bruins of UCLA against Kansas. Here we have 3 minutes, 3 seconds to play. 103-83.
New Mexico State ball out of bounds.
And the Aggies with a lob and a monstrous jam by Randy Brown.
Oh, yes, he's quick. He's got real quick jump.
Speaking of quick, Greg Walker in a hurry down the floor. Shot doesn't fall. Jeff Fryer recovers.
You know, as you look at Loyola Marymount, you've got to start thinking about, okay, what would they do against Michigan? You know, how do they play that kind of game? And the thing that they don't will not have or they'll see as much of is Michigan has a lot of good athletes that they can get after you. One of the players that will be guarding Bo Kimble will probably be Sean Higgins. He's 6'7". He can guard him to keep him from shooting a jump shot. But you got Ramil Robinson, so that's going to be a little bit different combination for Paul Westhead to think about.
Meanwhile, you can bet Coach Fisher and the Wolverines are doing some thinking about Bo Kimble, who has 43 points, 17 rebounds tonight.
Well, the 40, you see, he's got 7 40-point games this season. The thing that I'm as impressed with is the 17 rebounds. You know, he's 6'5", but what I've noticed about him is he's extremely quick to the basketball. When he sees it going up, you're watching get position, and if it doesn't come to him, he finds ways to go and get it.
45. 2.5 to play. Go, and the youngster Chris Knight with the rebound again. Here comes Bo, three-pointer. That one too hard, comes right back to him.
That's some senior leadership there. Bo, you don't need to practice your three-pointers out here. The other thing that'll be interesting is that Michigan's got something to be concerned about because they have those big bodies. Terry Mills and Lloyd Vaught, they're big kids, but have they run this much? There's nobody in the Big Ten that runs as much as Loyola Marymount, so they've got something to contend with as well.
That one batted out of bounds, and the Lions will inbound it. Just under 2 minutes now, minute 52 to play. And Loyola Marymount firmly in control. On Sunday here in Long Beach, it'll be Loyola Marymount against Michigan, Alabama against Arizona.
You know, the thing that's pretty amazing is Bo Kimble picked up his fourth foul with 7 minutes to go in the first half, and he's played the entire second half, basically, and not gotten that fifth foul, which is a credit to him and understanding that he had to back off defensively, but he stayed aggressive on the offensive end.
Number 14, John O'Connell, into the game, replacing Pierre Stumer. Stumer leaves the game with 11 points, 7 rebounds. And Chris Knight with his fifth point. Chris Knight, as we mentioned earlier, replaced Hank Gathers when he passed out and missed two games back in December, had 5 points and 10 rebounds against Oklahoma.
Well, he's capable of getting some things done, but he's got an opportunity to grow a little bit here in the tournament. It's a tough place to learn.
Flucky. Big-time three-pointer out of the corner for Rick Flucky. Goes for the steal, doesn't get it. Fryer off the glass. No. Knight follows. And O'Connell is fouled as he goes for the loose ball. John O'Connell, a 6'6 sophomore from Glenside, Pennsylvania. And the Aggie bench tells the story.
Yeah, they worked at it. I thought the Aggies did a good job, a very good job in the first half. They were able to keep the tempo their way. And they caused the turnovers and took advantage of them. In the second half, their problem was simply Bo Kimble. And it was not something they didn't do. It was what Bo Kimble did do. He just got hot. And when he gets hot and you come out and guard him at the three-point line, he backs up.
Chris Hickman into the lineup for New Mexico State. And Jeff Fryer out of the game. 23 points for Jeff Fryer. And wholesale substitutions now by Neil McCarthy. Nice gesture, and we mentioned it to Neil McCarthy yesterday. Nice gesture by the players, and it was the players' idea to wear a black patch on their uniform in memory of Hank Gathers.
Yeah, it really is something nice. You know, those guys, you know, hadn't even played against Hank Gathers, but they felt they wanted to show their respect and wore the black patches in honor of
him. Long jumper doesn't go by Flucky. Flucky will try another one.
Well, he's got that shooting mentality. Keep throwing it up there.
We approach 1 minute to play here in Long Beach. This is Peabody.
I'll tell you the other thing about Michigan playing, we were talking about, you know, looking down the road, about Michigan playing against Loyola Marymount. They're subject to get caught up in this rhythm of Loyola Marymount faster than New Mexico State, and that will just kill Michigan if they get caught up in Loyola's tempo.
And Bo Kimble will leave the game. Rebounds for Kimble. There's a steal by Flucky at half court, and he'll drive, and he'll go to the free throw line for two. Kimble wanted to make this a very special night and wanted to put forth a very special effort. He's done that.
He's done that, and I think he started pressing in the first half. He didn't get his first couple of goals in the rhythm that Bo Kimble would like them to have gone. And at half, it was enough time to get him to settle down, and he came out a little better focused, not as tight, and just had a great second half.
It's a close-knit team. It's been the very emotional times for them.
And this was a big test to see how well they've come through it.
Well, they've come through it with flying colors.
Marcus Slater, number 50, into the lineup now. And Tom Peabody leaves the floor for LMU.
With a big smile on his face. You see the hugs over there because, and that's the other thing about these guys. They've pulled together, you know, they've supported one another. And to get this win is to show that they're capable of pulling through some tough times.
Is Chris Hickman all over Greg Walker.
Fouls on 35. Chris Hickman, his first.
Quinn, that young man, Chris Hickman, we do not want to get into any kind of an intellectual discussion with him. An academic All-American nominee with a 3.5 grade point in electrical engineering.
That's what?
I was scared to death he'd say hello to me out on the floor.
Want to hold a little conversation with you.
Well, time to congratulate the Aggies on an excellent season. They went 16-0 at home this season. And with 16-2 record, co-champions of the Big West Conference.
They really did. The Aggies had a great season. I happened to be out in the West Coast and did a couple of their games. And they begged pretty hard to get some respect. But I think they've earned some people's respect with the way they played today.
Rick Flucky. Putting an exclamation point to his performance. Clock winds down. And that's it. Hugs all the way around and plenty of smiles on the faces of the Loyola Marymount faithful. Region in Long Beach, California. Our final score, Loyola Marymount 111, New Mexico State 92. Loyola Marymount now moves on to join Michigan, Alabama, and Arizona in second round play Sunday here in Long Beach. The Chevrolet most valuable players of our game, who else for Loyola Marymount? Bo Kimble and Randy Brown of New Mexico State. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the NCAA Championship. Let's rejoin Jim Nance in our New York studio. Jim?
The highest point total by a team in the first round and the highest individual performance, topping the 44 points by Travis Mays of Texas. Mike, you cannot stress enough just how truly remarkable this performance was tonight by the Lions. We had heard reports coming out of the West Coast this team may not be ready to play going in.
And when they started off so quickly, I wondered if maybe they just wouldn't have enough left after that first emotional burst. And Bo Kimble, 3 fouls 8 minutes into the game, 4th foul 4 minutes left in the first half. Then to put forth a performance like that, as good as I've seen in a long time, Jim, 33 second half points, 45 points in all, just a phenomenal performance.
I got to ask you, what about their chances against Michigan?
You know, it's a very compelling matchup. Of course, Loyola with the story, the Hank Gather story against the defending national champions. Playing them at that pace against Michigan is very tough. Michigan has as much talent as just about anybody in the country. Very tough matchup for Loyola.
Open floor game, you think, hurts them against Michigan?
Very
with all
tough
that talent.
To play them that way.
All